Nacadil and all, we won. He was on
back. I was on back.
He was on backboard.
Throw me off.
We were sailing down back at Sandman-Morecambre and all.
Right,
and sailing?
Sands,
no, sailing? He ain't getting stuck in that mud, but just off Sandgate.
What, rowed out there?
Not rowed out, in that mud, just off Sandgate shore.
All right.
Well, he walked back on.
Same time, 2 weeks afore, Jack Manning left his tractor, and then following week, Michael left his.
What, they mean they got stuck?
Aye,
yeah. They were in bed, but he was just in that mud off shore.
At each low tide in Morecambe Bay, 120 square miles of sand are left bare by the retreating sea. Only fishermen from the tiny village of Flukeborough scratch a living on the sands. And for them, the bay holds few surprises. Yet over the years, they have learned to treat it with respect. What they have learned of its ways, they describe in words you would never hear elsewhere. The people of Flukeborough have their own dialect.
In a small village, a small community like we have in Flukeborough, they have their own way of speaking, dialect as you call it, and this has been handed down really from generations. Now, for instance, a dike on the sands is just the opposite to what you would think it was. It's more or less a drain off, a dip, a hollow in the sand. And there's the melgraves, which are caused by the scouring tide, or melgraves, as I would say. All have different meanings. Brack means a breakaway, really. And as the tide come in, it's gushing against the brack and undermining it. And then eventually, the whole bank collapses into the water with such a noise like a crashing sound.
Cedric Robinson is an official guide of the sands, responsible for leading parties of tourists over the 12 miles from Morecambe to the Flukeborough shore, a walk that is never the same from one tide to the next.
Before each and every walk, the guide has to walk this, go across this stretch of sand, and is looking for changes. When you're leading a party of 150 to 200 walkers across 12 miles, you must know every inch of that area, and you can't leave anything to chance.
For his services as guide, Cedric Robinson receives £15 per year and a cottage called Guide Farm. The rest of his income comes from fishing in the traditional Flukeborough way. His daughter Jean works with him, and whatever the weather and at all hours of the day and night, they must cross the sands to see to their nets.
Being a fisherman is totally different to anyone else going to work, same as an 8-to-4 job. I mean, you're governed by the tides.
You better go around with them float nets, Jean, and drop them before going into the cockle.
It is a hard life fishing, actually, but it's a lifestyle which we wouldn't want to change, really. I'm too old to start anything else. Anyone coming in for a holiday and looking out onto the sands, they in summertime, they only see the best of it. But we have to take it all as it comes. Many times you go out there and you get out there and you do your work and you get home, and many times you're glad to get home. But when the summer comes, same as the sun gets out, by gum, it has its pleasures. And I wouldn't change my way of life for anything.
Channels and melgraves, bracks and dikes, special words to describe a special place. An hour after high water, it is just possible to cross the sands if you know the route. for the dikes are still swollen, and at the crossings, the tractor will often run axle deep. These nets are set to catch flukes, small flat fish rather like plaice. They're popular in Morecambe, but almost unheard of anywhere else.
Well, the fluke mainly lives down in the deep water and comes in up into the estuaries with the tide. They come out onto the banks to feed, and then on the ebb tide they make the quickest road back, and this is the areas where we set the nets and catch them.
I think we've dropped nets a little bit too early.
When flukes are caught in the nets, usually if a stranger was to walk along, half of the flukes are hidden under the sand. This is here. The Jan ears could easily have been missed. This is what you call ducked in sand.
Maybe you could see the eyes, the two eyes of the fluke, and just the outline, and that's called ducking.
Buried under sand. A good one and all. They leave a perfect imprint. One thing about these nets, there's no escape yens to get in.
Sands are bleak and featureless, and the weather changes quickly. A sea mist closes in, and in minutes the shoreline is lost. And if the tide is turning, a stranger has little enough time to find his bearings. Between the two rivers that feed into the bay, the sea is funneled into a bore, a tidal wave that sweeps the sands faster than a man can run.
Well, it's certainly an experience watching the tidal bore, but after saying that, you want to be somewhere safe to watch it. You get the rush of a train, a sound, which is a frightening experience, really, if you're out there on your own. But the danger is of being cut off is that with the silentness of the tide coming in behind you.
Everyone who works the bay goes cockling. The methods used to catch the small shellfish are traditional to Flukeborough, and so are the words used to describe them.
And let's open it among our beds. Two important words which we use in Flukeborough, actually, for cockling. Rank, which means plentiful, and weet means small cockles. Well, cockles aren't as rank as they used to be. Sometimes, I've seen out on the sands, there's been a set of weet, and the sand was just hissing with these young cockles. This looks a good area for cockles, Jean. Look, we've got a two showing up top, and quite a number of them spitting up. Look at them, all around. Yeah. Add some more, just get started. Get your headphones a little bit. Well, cockles are brought to the surface with the wooden board called a jumbo. This was a Flukeborough invention, actually. They don't use it anywhere else in the country. And anyone watching the Flukeborough fishermen cockling, they'll probably say, well, I wonder why they're using methods like this. Surely there's an easier way.